Here is the president last night.
America's heart broke the day after Christmas when a young police officer in California was savagely murdered in cold blood by an illegal alien who just came across the border. The life of an American hero was stolen by someone who had no right to be in our country. Imagine if it was your child, your husband, or your wife, whose life was so cruelly shattered and totally broken.
Corporal Ronald Singh's brother, Reggie, joins me now. Reggie, good to have you with us today. When you heard the president talk about your family, about your brother last night, what was that like for you?
It felt good that, you know, something's being done. Ronald's not coming back, but if we could do something about it and save other lives, law enforcement, any family, you know, we definitely don't want any other family to go through what we are going through right now. So President Trump is addressing the issue, and I just hope that it will be taken care of.
I want to play a little bit from the day on December the 28th. Your brother was killed by someone who was here illegally and who had two DUI arrests and was purported to be a member of a gang. He is the alleged killer, I should say, at this stage of the process. This is part of that news conference. Let's play that.
I wish I could thank all the law enforcement agencies, Homeland Security in San Francisco, everyone, Bakersfield team. I was waiting for this to happen. I'd like to thank you, working day and night, to make this happen.
Tell me a little bit about that moment for you, Reggie.
You know, Ronald looking down, I know all he wanted was justice. And, you know, suspect has been apprehended. And, you know, people work, a lot of law enforcement, you know, they work days and nights to make that happen. You know, it was heartbreaking. You know, Ronald's not coming back, but, you know, when the suspect was apprehended, you know, it felt good. It felt good, you know. Yeah.
I want to play a little bit of the Stanislaus County Sheriff, Adam Christensen, at that news conference talking about the alleged killer. Watch this.
Had he been deported, this wouldn't have happened?
Potentially. If he wasn't here, then he wouldn't have been driving drunk, and it wouldn't have been reported to Officer Singh, and the encounter, the stop, the enforcement stop, potentially never would have occurred. My point is, why are we providing sanctuary for criminals, gang members? It's a conversation we need to have.
I mean, it's so hard to watch, Reggie. Obviously, it's been such a difficult time for you and your family. Tell me your family came here. Tell me how your family came here and how you felt when you realized that the person who is responsible did not go through the same process.
So my family, we migrated in 2003. We got sponsored and we did everything legally. We came here. We were green card holders. And after 5 years, my brother, in my brother's case, he was asked to get his citizenship in order to become to be part of law enforcement. And he got his citizenship, and I was able to get my citizenship also. And we are now American, law-abiding American citizenship holders. And the day I found out that the suspect was illegal immigrant and had prior DUIs, two DUIs, my question was that why we did not react the first time he had a DUI if he's an illegal immigrant. And I feel like that we shouldn't be giving people second chance. Illegal immigrants, we shouldn't be giving a second chance to them. If he would have been deported. My brother would be alive right now. I would not be doing this interview. What I truly feel about this is, you know, if we make our immigration law stricter, if we take action and not allow an illegal immigrant to get second chance, I think that, you know, we could minimize the crime rate we are having.
You know, I know he was just recently became a canine officer, and I understand that the dog that he worked with, he was very close to, that dog is going to be given to the family, his wife and his young child, I assume. You know, talk to me a little bit about them, how they're doing. Give everybody a sense of all that.
So Sam's not doing well. He's locked in Ronil's bedroom. He is laying on his bed. He knows that Ron is no longer with the family.
This is the dog.
And he's sad. He's not active. This is the dog. Sam is the canine dog, and Sam's not active anymore. And at this moment, he is protecting my sister-in-law, the wife, and the baby, because Sam feels like that he needs to step up and protect the family now. So if my uncle or aunt tries to play with the baby, Sam does not like it. No. Sam feels like that, you know, Ron's not here, I got to protect the family now, because Sam is fully aware that Ron's not here. And our mourning, you know, starts with crying. I spent the night at my brother's house. I woke up, and yesterday my sister-in-law was crying. I go to my house, my parents is crying, and it's just every morning our day starts with crying.
That is, that's the grieving process. It doesn't help at all to hear that, because you wake up and the reality of what happened hits you all over again, just in case you forgot it when you were sleeping momentarily. And we feel for you, and we thank you for your brother's service, and we pray for your family. And we want everyone to know that there are a number of charities. There's a GoFundMe page, and Tunnel to Towers is also helping with some of your expenses. So, Reggie, thank you very much for being here today, and please know that our thoughts and our prayers are with you and with your family.
Thank you so much.